This is part 4 of solving rational equations. And keep in mind, a fraction is undefined if 0 is in the denominator. Alright, here's another problem. 2 over x minus 2 equals 8 over x minus 1. Alright, the first thing we should do is note what x cannot equal. Try that on your own. Alright, how do we do that? We look at each denominator. Right, one of the denominators is x minus 2. So x minus 2 cannot be 0, so therefore x cannot be positive 2. And the other denominator I have is x. Just x cannot be 0. So keep in mind, x cannot be either of those numbers. So if we go through the problem and we get one of those numbers for x, they really aren't going to be solutions. All right, so we've got two denominators. There's a couple ways we could do this. We can multiply all the terms on both sides by the least common denominator, or we could make all the denominators the same, have the same common denominator, and then make the numerators equal. Let's do this one by multiplying both sides of the equation by the least common denominator. All right, there's two denominators, an x minus 2 and an x. So the least common denominator, I'm just going to make a little note, the least common denominator is going to be x times x minus 2. So we're going to multiply each term on both sides times x minus 2. So we'll do the first one, 2 times x minus 2. I'm going to put that in parentheses, and we're going to multiply it times x minus 2. Right, next term on the other side of the equation is 8 over x, and we're going to multiply that also by x times x minus 2. And then I have minus 1, there's no denominator here, just the number 1, you're just going to multiply that times x minus 2. All right, let's see if anything cancels, because it should, that's the whole idea, multiplying by the least common denominator when you have an equation. So x minus 2's cancel. So on the left side, we just get 2x, right? By the way, you could put this on pause and try it on your own first all the way through. All right, now we have 8 over x times, okay, at least that. Those x's are going to cancel, right? So I have 8 times x minus 2. I'm going to go ahead and just leave it here. I'll wait on the next step to use my distributive property. And here we got to be careful. I got minus 1 times x minus 2. I'm just going to write that as minus x times x minus 2. Be careful of your minus sign there. So let's simplify the right-hand side. So we have a distributive property here, 8x minus 16, and we distribute the minus x through this parentheses. That'll be a minus x squared and a plus 2x. All right, we can keep simplifying the right-hand side by combining like terms. So I have a negative x squared, got an 8x plus a 2x, that's a plus 10x, and a minus 16. All right, so we've simplified both sides. Now we have to analyze this problem. What do I have going on here? I have a quadratic, so I have an x squared term. So you can't just put the variables on one side and constants on the other. We need to set the equation equal to 0 when you have a quadratic, anything with a higher exponent than 1. Let's go ahead and put everything on the left side of the equation. So I'll have an x squared on the left side. Now when I subtract 10x, can we do that in our head? 2x minus 10x will be minus 8x. And then I'm going to add 16 to both sides, so I'll have plus 16, and that's a way to get a 0 on the right hand side. So x squared minus 8x plus 16 equals 0. All right, now what? We factor. All right, so different ways of factoring. Try that. This happens to be a perfect square. You could either write it as x minus 4 quantity squared, or you could write x minus 4 times x minus 4. It really doesn't matter which way you do that, okay? So x minus 4 squared equals 0, basically saying the same thing. But I'm going to set each factor to equal to 0, but it's really the same factor, so I only have to write it down once. So x minus 4 equals 0, which means x is 4. First thing we want to make sure is that doesn't give a 0 in the denominator, and we look back up here at the original, and x can't be 0 or 2. Those are the two problem numbers that would give a 0 in the denominator. So what we want to do is plug in 4 into the original equation here and see if that gives us a true solution. So now we're going to check to see that x equals 4 is really a solution. So here's the original problem. I'm going to simplify each side after I plug in 4 for x. So we have 2 over 4 minus 2 on the left side, which is 2 over 2, and that 2 divided by 2 is 1. Okay, on the right-hand side, I've got 8 over 4 minus 1. 8 divided by 4 is 2, so 2 minus 1 is 1. So it checks. So that means the solution to this problem is 4. We checked it, and that was correct. Here's another problem. Let's do this by trying to make all the denominators the same, and it's easier to figure that out by factoring each denominator if it can be factored. So this first fraction, I mean, I'm sorry, this first denominator, x squared minus 4, can be written as x plus 2 times x minus 2. And the second one is can't be factored any further. We just have x minus 2. And I'm going to leave some space. I could see I'm going to have to multiply this fraction by something. And the right-hand one, we have x times x plus 2, and I'm going to have to multiply that by something. All right, so now we look, and we can hopefully see that the common denominator is going to be x plus 2 times x minus 2, but there's something else. What are the things that x cannot be? All right, what can't x be? Well, since x plus 2 can't be 0, x can't be negative 2. And since x minus 2 can't be 0, x also can't be positive 2. So you probably want to keep that in mind before you start. All right, so let's multiply this second fraction here times x plus 2 over x plus 2. So it has the common denominator. And the other fraction, we're going to multiply it x minus 2 over x minus 2. So now I've got all the denominators the same since the least common denominator is x plus 2 times x minus 2. So then the numerators are equal. So we have x plus 6. All right, now let's be careful. Think of this minus 2 times x plus 2. You could think of it as plus a negative 2 times x plus 2. So that's going to give you negative 2x and a minus 4 if you distribute your negative 2. And on the right side, we have x squared minus 2x. All right, hope you're doing this with me. All right, now let's keep simplifying the left-hand side. We've got x minus 2x, that's a negative x, and 6 minus 4 is 2. So we have negative x plus 2 equals x squared minus 2x. And here we go, we have another quadratic. So when you have a quadratic, you have to set it equal to 0. So let's keep the 0 on the left side since the x squared is positive on the right. So I've got x squared. Now if I add x to both sides, what's that going to give me on the right-hand side? Minus x, right? And I'm going to have to subtract 2 from both sides. And then here's our factoring that you could do on scratch paper. X minus 2 times x plus 1. So we're going to set each factor equal to 0. Either x minus 2 equals 0 or x plus 1 equals 0. So x equals 2 or x equals negative 1. Now let's go back up to the original. X equals 2. Check it out. It says x can't be 2. All right, well, you could just throw that one out. There's no reason to check that. We already know x can't be 2. So the only one we have to check is x equals negative 1, and we need to check that in the original. So we're going to check by writing the original equation and plugging in negative 1 everywhere there's an x, and we'll simplify the left-hand side and then the right-hand side. All right, so on the left-hand side, in the first fraction, we're going to have 5 for the numerator, 1 minus 4 for the denominator. Make sure you have to square negative 1. You need parentheses around the negative 1. And then we have minus 2 over negative 3. So we've got 5 over negative 3 plus 2 thirds. And this does not have the same denominator, so I need to write that as negative 5 over 3 plus 2 thirds, which is negative 3 over 3. And negative 3 divided by 3 simplifies to negative 1. On the right-hand side, we have to simplify the denominator, and that was a plus 2 there, so I get negative 1 over 1, which simplifies to negative 1. So I got the same number when I plugged in negative 1, therefore this checked, so our solution is negative 1, and that's the final answer to the problem.